It's Feedback Gaming, and we're continuing our Kaiserreich series with Alex, and we're pushing,
Kaiserreich!
Yeah, pushing further and further and further and further and further east. Mm. Yep.
Ooh. We're pushing on. We're getting on.
Prussian on. I thought there was a pun there. Prussian on.
Fuck you, Dave.
Oh, well. Well.
Let's just unpause and get this over with.
Yeah, so we are pushing further east right now. The plan I formulated, which is, I must admit, is an absolutely fantastic plan. You know,
oh, yes, it's the best plan.
Yeah, so we had different dilemmas. Do we push into the Middle East and do some kind of amphibious hop around Asia? Or do we go through Mongolia and the Maklik? Or do we just plow into Serbia and then go through the Weeaboo faction? And that was the... Anonymously, with one vote, that was the one we went for, isn't it?
Yep, yep. You were the guy with the vote, and you voted. Yep.
Actually, I think I did start the game as a democracy, but then I think something happened in the game that caused me to go one-party state.
Yeah, no elections.
Yeah, it's weird, because the start of the game, the first year, I get an election, so I don't know, there must have been something there I missed.
Must have been something you said, right?
Yes, it must have been. So,
am I able to keep the peace here? Not a chance.
So are we having supply issues? Yep, we are. Siberia is awful with supply. But we realized that it would have been even more worse if we pushed through the Mongolia. Mongolia has one. No, it's got five. Ooh, okay. That's different. So it appears that the infrastructure is a bit better. I think there's some buffs in this mod for Mongolia, isn't there?
I think Asia is buffed all round.
Yeah.
To be honest with you.
Yeah.
I have just about sunk all the Kaiserly fleets, all the bourgeois monarchist pig dog fleets in the Mediterranean.
Class system. Ugh. Class. There's only one class, and that is the workers.
The working class. The proletariat. Long live the proletariat.
Lol.
Oh shit!
How are we doing in USA?
Not too remember good. I said something about sinking his bourgeois fleets?
Oh yeah.
Yeah, he just sunk three of my carriers.
Oh boy. Whereabouts? Can you tell me where?
In the Red Sea.
The Red Sea? Where the fuck's that?
Right outside of through the Suez Canal.
Oh Suez god. Canal. You're being quite adventurous pushing them all out there, weren't you?
Yeah.
My fleet isn't... I don't feel like my fleet's strong enough to kind of be that aggressive, so I'm not bothered. I think the control of the Med is a bit uncontested at the moment, but the North Sea is locked down pretty nicely.
Yeah. Hang on.
Oh, I can see the areas that you're in, because they've got a green outline, meaning naval superiority.
Yep.
So, okay, the Axis seem to be pretty friendly with us because we can go through the Suez, can't we? Yeah, they're neutral.
Yep. They're going to pay for that. Oh, good, my main fleet is still around. That's a relief.
So, I'm still only getting a little political power per day. I think what we're going to do is we're going to not... We're not going to go for a national focus so I can build lots of political power. So my dream with this campaign is to go totalist, so I want to see if I can actually do that in this series.
Yep.
The push to the east is a little bit slow, but we're still making ground. The infrastructure's bad, but it's not horrific. Feedback game is lagging.
Finally, you were lagging.
Yeah, it's the internet. RIP.
That's what you get for living in a third world country.
Okay. Alright, okay, there's some divisions here burning out. Get them. Yeah, the internet I've got is relatively good. It's relatively good. I think for the most part it's fairly stable because I won't be able to stream otherwise, so that probably... plays a part in it.
Mm-hmm. Probably.
Probably, I feel like we're dipping into politics again, but my goodness, it seems that Iran and Saudi Arabia are allies.
What? That's perfectly plausible.
There you go.
Sunni, Shiite, I mean, same, really.
It's interesting, isn't it? Because they've kind of formed this almost like this oil faction almost, haven't they?
Mm-hmm.
I think that's kind of interesting. I kind of like that. Like countries kind of all butting heads together to try and, I don't know, hold on to their power almost.
I finally managed to get an industrial concern. How's that?
That's pretty sweet.
We're in 1941 and I get an industrial concern. Woohoo!
Industrial concern? Sorry, what's that?
That's those boosts you get to... it's instead of the advisors things where you can get different firms to... It reminds me a lot of Hearts of Iron 1 and 2.
Oh god, yeah. Yeah, there's some really good choices. I feel like in this mod that they're a little bit expensive, don't you think?
That's the idea. The idea is that they have made political points worth something, in that you can't just get everything you want and then end up with 2,000 of them on the table in 1943.
Yeah, but we're 7 years in and I don't even have one yet.
Yeah.
I don't really have one.
It wasn't really a problem when I was playing... I was playing as the Kaiserreich.
Can you just pause for a second? Fucking...
Okay.
Yeah, it's really difficult to... It's really difficult to specifically tail them to go to a certain direction, isn't it? When you're playing at normal speed. Alright, you can resume now, sorry. Yeah, it's really difficult to tailor them to go in a certain direction.
Tailor who?
Yeah, it's difficult to describe unless you can see it, but like you want your troops to move in a certain position or go in a certain direction, and it's difficult to tell them to go in that direction when...
That's why you're getting the paid feature of Blitzkrieg in the next DLC.
I guess so. I guess so.
I have to admit, that's one of the more dick moves I've seen from Paradox. I didn't expect them to charge for that kind of feature.
I love Paradox in every single way. There is nothing Paradox could ever do wrong, ever. Paradox is the perfect company.
Oh, somebody wants to retweet.
Give me the DLC early, please.
Could you please attack the 16th Division pocket?
I am. I've locked it in. The reason that exists is because I paused the game to go around it. That's what I was doing. Yeah, I'm trying. My main objective right now is to stop it from breaking open.
I'm trying to reinforce that too.
All right,
I'm moving divisions in that direction.
There you go. It's secure now. I've turned on them.
Oh, thank you. Because that had me worried. Because 16 divisions, that's something worth catching.
Don't question my expert tactics, Mr. Alex.
Never, comrade. I would never question your tactics.
To the
Why did I turn into a Russian? I'm an English communist. They're what, Cockney or something? Governor?
Maybe.
Never question your tactics, Governor.
That's it.
That was the worst Cockney ever, but I apologize.
All right, so veteran difficulties improving relations with Russia. Why am I even doing that? Okay, so... Oh, man. The syndicates of America were doing really well, and they've kind of got split in the middle, and... Am I still sending stuff to them? Yeah, I'm still sending stuff to them.
Am I still sending stuff to them?
Yeah.
I'm still sending stuff to them.
Yeah, I think they've recovered a little bit now, because they've now joined up their Eastern Western Front with Chicago again. But I don't know how long that's going to last.
Which is their capital, apparently?
Yeah. Yeah, well, it's not the best location for a capital right on the front line, I would say.
Well, keeps you in contact with the front line.
Yeah, so I don't think this mod fully has the ability to change faction, other than... Go on, sorry, what's going on?
No, you said change.
Changes, yeah. Yes. It doesn't really have a way of changing. I have to stumble on my words. I feel like I have to put loads of buts. Yeah, so there are events that can change your ideology, but it feels like when those events dry up, like later in the game as it is now, you don't have as many options.
Yeah, that's probably something they're going to have to work on in the long run, isn't it? To make sure there are decisions and events that happen after 1940. But I have noticed they do some cheeky stuff with the early wars, where they end in white peace, but it turns out that white peace isn't so white, if you know what I mean.
What do you mean?
Some wars are declared, and it says white peace, but like the war with India and Afghanistan ends in a white peace, but it turns out Afghanistan becomes an ally of India and Canada.
Right.
I don't know if it gets puppeted.
Do you know, I think that's
it becomes a puppet. There's and that's probably by event.
Now I think about it, I think there is something in the main game that causes that, you know. It says white peace, but yet they've taken land as... It feels to me like, I know this is really rare in this game, but you sometimes can negotiate a peace. It doesn't happen so much when two big factions are fighting each other, like an actual world war. But if that actually happens and they negotiate a peace, for some unbelievably bizarre reason, when the peace is negotiated and it ends, and one faction wins by taking land, it still says white peace. So maybe that's actually a bug in the game. Maybe Paradox realized that the actual eventuality of an actual peace offer is when it's not a complete capitulation. It's so rare that they've not even actually fully coded the thing in. Who knows?
It's not going to be an issue.
Yeah, I don't know. It's one of the two. Okay, so what I'm doing right now is I'm changing all my cabinet to Totalist, and I want to see if the events that pop up start to move towards Totalist. I've got some funny feeling they're not going to, but I don't know. We'll see.
It's worth them.
Yeah. It's really tempting because I go into National Focus and I can see those really cool events with social engineering, and I can't do it unless I'm Totalist, so...
I need more support equipment. Damn. Huh.
There's been so many times where my supply equipment's got low, and I never make that mistake anymore. Because that really, really does slow you down as well.
Yeah, it hurts a lot. Hurts a lot more. And it screws over your logistics as well.
Yeah. So we do have the Belgrade Pact faction as well. Let's have a look. So this is...
A bully for them.
I'm just have a look. Nationalist, populist, that sounds fascist to me. And
populist is the Nazi faction for this
month. But that's funny, the only nation that has it is... I guess Germany has the option to go for it as well if it picks the right events or the national focus.
Russia.
Russia does as well. Okay.
Yeah. Russia is sort of the random guy in this mod, but they will go ape shit if the right decisions are taken. They will just go hardcore Nazi and ruffle stomp around Asia and stuff like that.
You can go 5-speed if you want now.
Oh yeah.
It was probably my internet hiccuped for a second. That's probably the reason why it dropped down.
I blame the internet.
Does the internet?
Like I said, I'm gonna get an i7 computer after Christmas.
The new models have just been released, so you've jumped on the bandwagon just at the right time there.
Yep, I saw one of those. I was Linus Tech Tips, I think.
Yeah.
I was talking about what the best computer to buy right now is, and I thought, mine's 2 years old. It's time for an upgrade. Actually, it's 3 years old.
I think mine is just over a year, actually.
Yeah, yours is still going strong, isn't it?
Yeah, fairly good. I kind of bought one that was slightly future-proof, and I had that in mind when I bought it.
Yeah. I always go, you know, top mid-tier when I buy computers. I don't buy the sort of just the middle-of-the-road stuff. I spend a little bit extra money, so I don't have to upgrade so often.
That's exactly my mentality, yeah.
I think a lot of people do, to be honest with you.
Unless money is no object, and then you can buy a god-tier PC.
Yes.
What was the Lyric PC? I think it was 10 grand he spent on his PC.
I like the Linus Tech Tips one, where they spent 30 grand on one.
Yeah?
And they can have 7 players playing on it.
Oh,
at once.
Yeah, I saw that. Yeah. That was interesting. Very, very interesting.
Uncouth. No, wait, what?
Okay.
Ooh, I got a discount on Marines, but we're gonna get weapons level 3, and I'm gonna have to upgrade my production.
There's parts of this game that give me flashbacks of Hearts of Iron 2 because you read the political ideology of a country, and they're the same ideologies that were in Hearts of Iron 2.
Mm-hmm.
The names of them. And if anyone ever played Hearts of Iron 2, you didn't pick an ideology like fascism, communism, democracy. It was a bunch of slider bars, and depending on where the position of your bars were, depending if you were left or right or democratic or authoritarian, it would based on some algorithm in the game, it would pick you and give you
a name.
Wasn't
Heart of Iron
2?
3 like that, too?
I don't play 2. I didn't play 3.
No, it had the sort of, you could move people towards your faction by influencing them politically, and they would... Oh, somebody offers their services. Lawrence will be valuable to spread the revolution. Where are his socialist credentials? Ah, sure, he'll be valuable. I have no idea who it is or what that entails. But it's a decision. I could press it, so I pressed it. That's what you're supposed to do in a game, isn't it?
Yes, sir. You see the option and you seize it.
Send Lawrence to Germany. Sure, take 500 military equipment and go to what's left of Germany. That's going to be glorious.
I feel
he's
like...
going to start a communist revolution in Germany.
Oh, wow, okay.
So good luck with that.
Yeah, so I was talking about Hearts of Iron 2. Yeah, so there's the left and right and democratic and authoritarian. And based on where the sliders aligned, it gave you an ideology. And some of the ideologies in this game are the same ones that were in, like, paternal autocrat. That, a lot of countries started with that in Hearts of Iron 2.
Yeah, all of Eastern Europe is paternal autocrat.
Market
I think they
liberal.
Still are to this day.
Yeah, market, social democrat, social conservative. Yeah, they were all in there as well.
Mm-hmm.
I think one
paternal
day,
autocrat just means king, I think.
Yeah, I saw in your comments someone said that. I actually googled it, and apparently it just means someone who is an unelected leader and they don't hold totalitarian control. There is some kind of council or upper house that can make decisions on their behalf. It's not absolute control. It's not like a totalitarian or a dictatorship.
Okay.
It can be the Republic or a monarchy. It can be one of the two.
Keep the Lend-Lease up for...
Yeah, dude, I'm still sending them.
Although, if they lose, it gives us an end-level boss, doesn't it?
Yeah. I wonder if those ones to the west are still getting supply.
Yeah, I was wondering the same thing, to be honest with you.
If you think about it, though, they could go around South America, couldn't they? Thinking, who owns the Panama Canal?
Who owns the Panama Canal? Canada?
Yeah, let's see. Can we go?
Yeah, they get an event for that.
Do they? Okay.
Yeah, they do.
Yeah, we talked
about...
They
get an event to pick up New England, too. And then you can turn yourself into New England. I discovered that to my dismay.
Wow, that's actually kind of cool.
I was doing Canada playthrough, and I'm like, oh, I'm Canada now, and ooh, I got Alaska, and ooh, I got Panama, and ooh, I got New England. I am New England. Fuck! Congrats with your one factory. Good luck. Glorious.
Yeah, I was saying on the previous game, wasn't I? I was saying about, oh, you become the new New England. The new New England.
You can actually literally become New England.
So we have three ministers now that are all totalists and only one that's a radical socialist. So I'm kind of hoping that the event that fires randomly gives me the option to see if I can move slightly more towards totalist.
Yep. It's going to be interesting to find out at any rate.
Yeah. Oh, okay. I think they've capitulated. Oh, there you go. I've gained a load of land out of nowhere.
Huzzah!
It's kind of weird to see that event right in front of my eyes. That's so bizarre. Okay, so I'm going to move my troops into position now. I'm going to build up some roads and build up some ports too.
Soviet Russia took all of it, and you got the tail.
Yeah, I saw. Yeah.
So, are we gonna go through the Fengitarian Republic?
Yes.
Yeah, and they're allied to the Japanese. This will bring us into war with Japan.
Yeah, that's right. Yeah, that was the plan. So that means we only have to declare once, and then we have control over that region.
Can you improve the infrastructure over here?
Where are we looking?
On the border with Japan there.
Oh, yeah, that's exactly what I'm doing right now. Yeah, that's good. Exactly what I'm doing, yeah. Yeah, I'm doing that good. Now. I'm only partially mobilized, though. I need to... With the lack of political power, you find yourself kind of, like, I don't know, not as, you can't do as much. Which I think is kind of cool, you know, because if you are trying to be a fascist dictatorship and you want to go to war, you kind of, you're held, I really like that concept. I feel like it's an idea that feels like, I don't know, they're onto something really great, but I imagine that it could be improved upon and built upon even more.
Yeah, but I don't think they're done by any means.
Oh, no, no.
So.
Okay, I think it's time to put logistics onto these guys.
Yeah, I just recently put logistics in all my divisions.
Yeah. I don't have it researched, what an idiot.
That's a noob mistake.
Aye. You can go 5-speed if you want, dude. As I do, it's just the internet taking a farting a little bit, that's all it's doing.
Yep.
We got any planes? No. I was playing earlier today and I was doing a combination of light tanks and air superiority. My god, the effectiveness on flat terrain is absolutely mad.
Oh, they actually work?
Oh, hell yeah. It's because when you get air superiority, it reduces movement speed of the enemy. And because of that, can go fast, you can smash into them and break through, move them out of the way. And when they're running away, they get reduced movement speed, so you have a higher chance of overrunning them.
Proper blitzkrieg.
Yeah, it is. Yeah, it is. Yeah, I guess so. The Pacific States of America has joined the Coercive Sphere. Interesting.
That means we're at war with them, yeah?
Well, no, we're not actually at war with them. They're about to get crippled and destroyed. But that means that the syndicates of America have got something else to deal with, which is kind of annoying.
No, they've been at war with them for a long time.
Oh, no, I know that, but it means that what's going to happen is the other divisions from the Coercive Sphere are going to push into them and do some more damage to our syndicate faction.
Okay, sure.
Yeah, because for instance, they're going to send volunteers, and they're going to send...
they're going to have their hands full.
Yeah, yeah, yeah. That's what I'm trying to say. Yeah, yeah.
Everyone's going to have their hands full.
Let's have a look what's going on. So Japan is very, very strong. They've got a lot of divisions. So I need to go total mobilization.
You also need to build up this infrastructure before we can declare this war, because we are just bleeding manpower.
Yeah, yeah. Oh, shit.
I'm pulling my stuff off the front line. You can stay.
Yeah, I was just okay, and then you put troops on, and it's caused more of an issue. Yeah, pull them off for the time being.
Yeah, could you please improve the infra in the north of the area so I can...
I'm doing it, bro. I'm doing it. I'm sorry.
Improve all the infra.
Yeah, dude. Trust me, I'm doing it. Remember the death of Lenin. Rest in peace, Lenarino.
Rip in pepperonis, my good man. Rip in pepperonis.
Okay, we're going to go total mobilization now, and I'm going to get zero manpower. Total mobilization. No, we're not, because we don't at war with anyone. We're 50% of the total factories. Oh, my goodness.
Yep, you're too late for that, my friend.
Yeah, I guess so. Oh, my God, really? That's so annoying. We're over 100% world tension as well. That is so frustrating. Yeah. Can't know about that. Never mind. Mm-hmm. I can't even go war economy either. it would give him more civilian factories, wouldn't it? Yeah, I was thinking to myself, why would that benefit the area? So it seems to me that the syndicalists are, I don't know about you, but they're just, I guess what's happened here is they're a socialist democracy. They're social democrats, aren't they? That's what they are. Oh, no, they're not. There is a social democrats in this game.
I think they're kind of a bit more hardcore than that.
Well, yeah, I know, but the fact that I can't really do anything is so frustrating that it makes me think, like, yeah, I guess what I'm trying to say is it's not totalitarian, is it? I've got a lot of people I've got to go through to make changes and whatnot. That's what it's meant to demonstrate.
Yeah.
Okay, so how do I alter this division? Let's take off. This is a bad idea, but it's temporary.
I think that's what they said about invading Poland.
We'll be home by Christmas.
No worries, mate.
Nope. We're, oh boy.
So the German Empire is still teetotaling around Africa.
So it won't let me change my head of state unless I am a totalist. So I've done all. I guess I've wasted all my political power on that. Because it's made no difference.
Learning by doing. Yeah, learning by failing.
It's not actually done anything. Oh well. Oh well. Yep, so this is, I guess, the waiting game until we can build some more infrastructure, isn't it? Because the truth is, this is going to be our tough battle.
How are you doing for total factories?
Total amount, we have 139. Seems a lot, doesn't it? Yeah, to be honest with you, every single one of the infrastructure that we've assigned right now is building. So, we're going as quick as we can go, and I'm building ports as well to try and get the most out of this as well.
I'm trying. Oh shit, my troops didn't pull off the line, did they? Nope, because they don't want to go to that place I told them to go to.
I just thought for a second, I wonder why it was so high still. I am making some logistics, so it is going to drop suddenly in just a moment. Yeah. 14 days.
14 days. Yeah, I'm pulling off the line now.
So with the new DLC that's coming out, they're going to give you an extra use for political power now. So there's things you can research and give your country buffs that'll have like a base reduction of political power per day. And you can stack them by loads of amounts if you've got lots of political power. So now, cool. We'll never end the game now with 2,000 political power. You'll have things to invest your political power into. And that's really good for me, because not only is that going to affect the base game radically, but that means the modders are going to have so much extra they can do. Can you think of some of the buffs they could do for political power, actually, mid-game? This mod would benefit a lot.
Yep, definitely.
So it looks like... So there is a faction that's right on the tip of Canada... of China, the German faction China, and it's called Legonation Cities, is that right? And it's got like, there's loads of little provinces all dipped around China. It's like a colony almost, but it's not a colony because it's not a puppet.
Legation Cities.
Yeah,
those are trading enclaves, I think.
All right.
So, like, independent little mini-states. You get the option to eat those as the German East India Company.
Ah, right. Okay.
Because that's the last Let's Play I'm doing for the pre-release thing is I'm trying my hand at the Allgemein Ostengeschäft thing.
All right, what is that? Oh, is that the actual name of the nation? Yeah.
Yeah.
What does that translate to in German?
The German East Asian Company, I think.
Well, what do you know? What you thought? What it sounds like is what it is.
German is very much like that. Like Nebelwerfer, I Nebelwerfs. That's completely wrong. But you get points for trying. Sturmgeschütz, it geschützt Sturms.
If you want to focus into a different area to give it a shot, just feel free. I mean, the worst thing that's going to happen is that it's going to... I imagine that probably someone else is going to join the German faction. That's probably what's going to happen.
Yeah, if we declare in Mongolia, for instance, they're just going to join the German faction.
No, they won't, because they've already got their own alliance, which is...
Ew. If
you want to give that a shot and go for that, why not? At least then we'll be hitting Japan.
They have 5 infrastructure. That seems...
Dude, yeah, I know. That's what I was just saying before. They're scraping the barrel too, so that you're about to squish them for good. With our political power gains, we have a chance to improve our stability. Shall we do it? Increase stability costs 200 political power. Yeah, sure.
Ooh.
And we've got good stability now, and that reduces consumer goods amount, which is really good for us because that means we can make more roads.
why do I have German marching songs?
Yeah, yeah.
That just seems so wrong. And that bombshell, I think it's time to end the episode. So will you do the honors?
Yeah, that's right, guys. If you enjoyed, remember to like and subscribe and also drop us a comment below how you feel the series is going. Guys, I hope you all have an awesome day and I will see you next time.
Cheers!